Hi, this is Jeptyon Mutai from jeptyon.com. In this video, I'm going to share with you top 10 requirements in Kenya that you need in order to qualify for a tender. If you are here for the first time, I ask you that you thumbs up this video and subscribe to this YouTube channel. Every year, new requirements to qualify for a tender in Kenya are piling up. Why? It's because there are many people applying for the tender, and most of the people qualify for the tender application. So how do they filter the number of applicants so that they remain with those very competitive ones in the market? These are the top 10 requirements in Kenya that are mandatory in order to qualify for a tender. The first requirement is the certificate of incorporation or certificate of registration. This is issued by the AG, the Attorney General GEMPAS, but with the current technology, we are living in a tech world. This is a certificate that you can get from the eCitizen platform. You just upload a few requirements, you sign up, and then you just upload the requirements that they need in order for you to get the certificate. Once you make the payment, which is about 850 for the certificate, and 10,000 to 35,000 for the limited company, it will take between, for the certificate, the registration of the certificate, it will take like 5 days, and then for the limited company registration, it will take between 2 to 3 weeks and some other time a whole month to get the certificate. So the second requirement for pre-qualification for tender, to qualify for a pre-qualification for tender, is a copy of your PIN certificate. You can use your personal PIN for this case. And then for the limited company, you need to go to KRA and request for them to give you a PIN number. You can go to KRA and get a PIN for the company so that it can be independent. So the third requirement is a copy of VAT certificate. In order to maybe use legally the ETR machine, you must have a VAT registration number, which is issued by KRA. Number four requirement is copy of valid tax compliance certificate. A tax compliance certificate is issued by KRA as well. This requirement is to ensure that you are faithfully paying your taxes on time, or you're remitting your taxes via the iTax portal. This cannot be forged, because this KRA, the iTax system, has the TCC checker, the tax compliance checker, whereby the client can copy the number inside the tax compliance certificate, and they can check if it's valid. Number five requirement is registration certificate with regulatory bodies. This, for example, I'm in the media industry. Sometimes companies request that I issue them, or I submit my registration with the Kenya Film Classification Board or the Media Council of Kenya. Number six is original bank statement. This is also good for them to check your, maybe your credit background or your transaction history, and also for them to know that you can be paid, you are operating legally in Kenya. Number seven is business or company profile. This is the one that you design it yourself, so you can find a designer, and the business company profile structure is dependent on what you're selling. It must, however, contain the name of the company, the contact, the services that you're offering, name of the employees that you work with or the partners that you work with, and their qualifications, as well as the past tenders that you've completed, indicating the value of those tenders that you've done, as well as referees that people that the company can contact in case they need clarifications on some things. Number eight is CR12 partnership deed. CR12, you can get it from the eCitizen platform. You pay, I think, 600 shillings, and you can get the CR12. This CR12 indicates everything about the company, the shareholding of the company, the nominal shares, issued shares, and and what a few. Number 9 requirement is the ACPO certificate for the youth and people with disabilities. With the knowledge that government is allocating 30% of all tenders to youth and people with disabilities, it is therefore necessary to register and obtain the ACPO certificate from the ACPO website if you fall in this category or if you are applying for a tender in this category. This way, you will have an upper hand in qualifying for tenders set aside for the youth and people with disabilities. Number 10 is the national IDs and passports for all directors, partners and sole proprietors. And lastly, firms' audited accounts or bank statements from the previous year. You might notice that I had previously mentioned about the bank statement, but for this case now, you are required to submit your audited accounts for your company to indicate that you've been actually in business and you've been doing your accounts really well. Then lastly, names of at least 3 clients that the firms have done business with in the last 2 years. This is a reference or recommendation letters from the companies that you've worked with to indicate that you have delivered the projects that is in the category that you're applying or you're tendering for. And that is it for this video. Thank you for taking your time to watch this video. And if you're here for the first time, again, thumbs up this video and subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you have a question regarding to this video, send me an email to connect@jeptioni.com. You can follow me on Twitter @jeptioni. Until next time, bye-bye and take care.